so wonderful. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me in here. Listen, I feel like I'm at home, so. Sam Cooke said it like this. God was a woman in the night of day. So she decided, join the gathering throng, while pushing her way through. Someone asked the question, what is she trying to do? She said, if I can just touch the hem of his heart, I know I. Y'all ain't gonna talk. Some of y'all might be sitting next to one right now. But sometimes you gotta tell that man. tell them, say, if you ain't happy, don't try,
try to stop me.
Thank God.
But this lady said, I don't know what you're coming to do. But God been too good to me.
God been
too good. For me to stand here like God owe me something. All of us owe God some praise. I don't care what you've been through, how much money you live, how much money you got. Baby, you still owe God some praise. I just need two or three of y'all in here that can say, out of all I've been through in my life, I'm standing on the promises of God. And I just need that you can look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor. That was one of you looking at him. Just look at him and say, neighbor. I've been called everything but a child of God. So, tell your haters. So, the more you talk about me, the more God is elevating. I want you to do me one favor. Look at the neighbor one more time. Say, neighbor, no matter what they say, it wasn't true. Because God got greater with your name on it. Some of y'all won't even say nothing right there. But when you look at God, God got greater for you. But some of us so sophisticated that God won't open the door for because you won't do nothing. I went to the hospital when I was blessed to walk back out. We take for granted the steps that we take. But today is my mother's 70. She turned 70 today. Ain't God good? My mother, 10 years ago, was in a car wreck because she wouldn't wait on me when I got off work to take her to go get her Thanksgiving food. So she got in her car, didn't wait on me, and somebody T-boned her and it broke her ankle into 9 pieces. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me in here. They had to reconstruct my mama's leg. 7 days I had to wipe my mother. I had to clean her because she couldn't even clean her own self. Y'all don't want to talk to me anymore. My mama looked at me and said, baby, I never thought that my baby boy would have to do this to me. I said, mama, I ain't got but one mama. And I said, you've been so good to me. It don't make no difference if I have to pick you up every day. I'm going to do it because I love my mom. Listen, listen. Her ankle was broken into 9 pieces. My mama went from being bedridden to a wheelchair. Ain't God on that. When she got in the wheelchair, she said, she saw a commercial where there was a motorized wheelchair. She said, baby, I want one of those. I said, I went and cut the TV off. I said, you ain't gonna need it because you're gonna walk again.
Yes, sir.
I wish I had some faith folks in here. She went from the wheelchair to a walk. Look at Jesus. Look at Jesus. Look at Jesus. And out for my mama.
Yes, sir.
Went from a walker to a cane. Ain't God all right? The doctor said she would never walk again. But can I tell y'all, on her 70th birthday, she walked. Without a walker, she walked. Without a cane, look at your neighbor.
See, I know we ain't rehearsing like this. But our group, it's been 29 years we've been together. I know guys like my brother Darius and Jermaine Spud, they ain't been with us the whole time. But I used to ask you for a Willie Banks call. And I want you to, I know we, see, some people don't know where Moscow, Tennessee is. I'm from Memphis, Tennessee. If you ain't, you done heard of Memphis, right? Amen. Moscow is where we, they gave us a chance to come sing. My big mama, not me, we ain't got big mamas now. That's where my big mama's from. That's what my cousin said is from. But Steve, I just want you to give me that guitar. If you don't mind, I'm gonna sing this song and I'm gonna shout my way out of here. No. See, I like that. Y'all might not, but I like that. Can you do something for me? I'm gonna say it like this. I know a lot of y'all groomed up now, if it got cold outside. Not folks looking for their teddy bear. You better watch yourself here, man. I'm out of the teddy like King Jordan. Can't stay too long. They're gonna say it like this. Yeah. Before we make our way back towards Memphis, I want to say to every single, every preacher, every last one of us that picks up an instrument, if we can't live what we sing, I can give you a good 3-point sermon, but my sermon don't mean nothing if I can't treat folk right. We have to know that we live in the last days. Neighborhood I grew up in, y'all might have heard of the rapper named Young Dolph. Mm-hmm. He got killed where I grew up. Same cookie spot where he went and bought cookies. Is where I would get out of work and go buy cookies for my children. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me anymore. Rappers dying like flies. The enemy is everywhere. And a lot of churches still worried about who ain't showing up. I told my church this morning, I ain't worried about the ones that don't show up. I'm thankful for the ones that do. Because the COVID didn't show me nothing else. It showed me that people were not committed to God. They were committed to the church. Because if you're committed to God, you don't show up for church. Because the church is rock. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. One thing we got to remember, I can sing all day. I can preach all day long and still miss heaven. Because the call y'all gonna talk to me. Because all my pride that got so in the way until what God is trying to show. We celebrated our anniversary about 4 years, three years ago. I went and preached for a pastor that morning. The pastor accidentally gave me the wrong envelope. On his appreciation, he gave me his honorary instead of mine. We met up after it was over. Gas station in Memphis, give me an E-key. When we met up at the gas station, my two baby boys was in the car with me. Are y'all gonna pray with me? I know we gotta go with God. We just step through here and everybody else, amen. We ought to want to hear something that God got to say. Two of my sons was in the back seat. Got to the gas station, wasn't even there 3 minutes. Behind the gas station. Are y'all praying with me? I didn't have time to call Abraham. I didn't have time to call Isaac. I didn't have time. I wish I had two of y'all in here. And though I didn't have time to call all the other names, I jumped in my car. I said, in the name of Jesus. Something ought to happen when you hear the name Jesus. But we done got so comfortable that hearing his name that we wonder why it ain't gonna change yet. Well, if you don't put nothing in it, you ain't gonna get nothing out of it. Are y'all praying with me? While I'm sitting in the car, one of the government tried to open the door. But the door didn't open. The second gunman tried to bust my window out, but the window didn't bust. Y'all gonna catch it in a minute. The last gunman pointed the gun at me, and I thought about my boys that was in the back seat. So I turned to take the shot. I saw his arm go up, but a bullet never came out. I got away from that. And when I got away, the Lord told me. just